Facebook's new timeline affords the opportunity for creating a cover photo as a sort of masthead to one's page. In this tutorial, I'm going to use both Lightroom and Photoshop in tandem to create a pre-visualized, ready-to-upload photo we can use for this purpose. Now, why is it so important to pre-visualize what we upload to Facebook? We can simply upload any photo at whatever pixel dimensions and resolution, and their setup will automatically force the photo to fit within the rectangular window. When our photo lands inside the live template Facebook provides, you can click and drag to reposition your photo there, but it is likely that the image you choose initially just won't work. The photos we shoot will not look right within a window where the width is nearly 3 times larger than the height. Even if we were all cinematographers and familiar with the variety of aspect ratios utilized for shooting feature films today, the ratio of width to height for the cover photo in the timeline is unlike anything any of us has ever worked with before. And think about this. For business, it is essential that our Facebook content looks and reads as professional as possible. A personal Facebook is pretty much about goofing with our friends, whereas a Facebook page for one's company, for an organization, or some serious cause is altogether different. Now first I had to know, before I got down to experimenting with various images in Lightroom, what sort of aspect ratio Facebook's cover photo area has for us to work inside their layout. In Photoshop, after cropping a screenshot I made to the edges of the existing cover photo, I opened the image size dialog to check on its dimensions. Drop down from the image menu to image size, or utilize the keyboard shortcut Ctrl+Alt+I on a PC, or Command+Option+I on a Mac. Next, I had to do some math to help me figure out what I would dial in as an aspect ratio later in Lightroom. I opened the calculator and divided 900, my intended upload size for Facebook, by the actual width of the cover photo window I just made a screen capture of, 851. Here's my result. I decided to round the number off to 1.06. Then I multiplied the height equation I got from the image size window, 315, and got nearly 334 pixels tall. I decided to round this off to 335 instead. So now I had my aspect ratio, 900 pixels wide by 335 pixels tall. In Lightroom, I need to choose an image I want to convert, so I start in the library, in the grid view. As you can see here, I already have a number of saved, formatted images I worked on earlier. To the left of each image saved for use as a cover photo, you can see the master file each virtual copy was generated from. To illustrate the process, I'm going to choose a new photo from within this collection. I tap the D key and move with my selected image into the Develop module. Note that at the top of the right column above the Basic panel is the Crop and Straighten tool. Click on the tool icon to open its Options panel. You'll see there is a crop overlay already in place from a previous snapshot version of the photo. I'm going to go to the aspect line of the tool options and click on the up, down facing arrows. This will provide me access to a series of aspect ratio settings Lightroom built in for us to work with, along with an additional series of user aspect ratios I have saved in the past. I've been saving a few of my photographs with the Facebook cover photo aspect ratio, so it is available for me here to select already. However, I'll show you now how to accomplish this for yourself. Select the Enter Custom option from the Options pop-up, and Lightroom generates a window for us to type in an aspect ratio with a pair of settings. The left field is for our width, the right field is for height. The aspect ratio settings need to be simple as possible, so I do some quick math in my head and convert the intended size for the Facebook cover photos, 900 by 335 pixels, to 9 by 3.35 instead. Then hit the OK button to create the new custom aspect ratio. Lightroom automatically replaces that initial crop I already had in place with the new 9 by 3.35 aspect ratio crop overlay, as you can see here. Now for a quick tip. The designers at Adobe have provided us a feature here in Lightroom that is not shared with ACR or Adobe Camera Raw when you're editing your photos within Photoshop. This is the lights on, lights dim, and lights off work environments. We normally do all of our work in Lightroom with a lights on mode. However, by tapping the L key once, Lightroom moves us into the lights dim mode, effectively spreading a shade effect across the entire screen, except for the image we are working on. This overlay helps us better focus on the image, yet we can still see the settings panels so that the lights dim mode is excellent for concentrating on our image while we are still working with the sliders in the right column of the develop module. However, I find that by tapping the L key a second time and moving into the lights out mode, while working with the crop tool, I am better able to set an even more specific, more finely tuned crop. Now in the lights out mode, I can place my cursor inside the live crop template and drag the master image up or down. I can take the edge handle and drag in, or a corner handle and drag diagonally. All the while, Lightroom maintains our active aspect ratio. We can play to our heart's content without any distraction from anything else sharing screen space while we tweak an optimum crop for our purposes. Because I utilize two monitors at my workstation, I find the lights out and lights dim modes to be indispensable while I'm working to fine-tune my photographs. Tap the L key a third time and Lightroom takes us back into the standard work environment again. When I have committed to the crop I like, I immediately save this point in my editing history as a snapshot. I click on the plus sign in the snapshots panel in the left column of the develop module, and when the new snapshot dialog opens, I type in a number, a right parenthesis symbol or hyphen, and then create a title that is pertinent to the snapshot I am saving. In this case, Facebook cover version 1. Now what? This crop version of my original master image needs to also be saved as a virtual copy. Virtual copies are another feature built into Lightroom that Adobe Camera Raw does not share. Place your cursor inside the content window, right-click or control-click on a Mac, and in the pop-up list that appears, choose Create Virtual Copy. I'm happy with this version of my photo for use in Facebook's timeline. I need to get this out of Lightroom and into a place I can easily find when I'm ready to upload it or move the image on into Photoshop for additional tweaks I won't be able to do inside of Lightroom. For export, I move up to File in the menu and drop down to Export, or it may be useful to learn the keyboard shortcut in Lightroom, Shift-Command-E on a Mac, Shift-Control-E on a PC. This will open up the export dialog where you will see that I already have saved a user preset specifically for my Facebook cover photos. Let's have a look at how I set this up. I've decided I want to export to the same folder as my original photo and to have Lightroom automatically add the photo to my catalog. I also want to choose a new name for my exported file. In the file naming panel, I have created some custom text I normally use for files I've initially worked on in Lightroom for export. Because the Facebook cover photos are destined for the web, I select sRGB as the color space as an 8-bit PSD file. Now, why export as a Photoshop document rather than choosing JPEG instead? Because I know that I normally intend to add a custom watermark and possibly add some text or composite a texture over the image in Photoshop, and if I'm going to do an additional pixel editing in Photoshop, I do not want to be working on a JPEG file. Next, in the image sizing panel, I check the resize to fit box and tell Lightroom I want the long edge to be 900 pixels wide at a resolution of 72 pixels per inch. I've done a bit of sharpening already earlier in my Lightroom editing process, so I leave this panel untouched. I check the Minimize Embedded Metadata option so that the only metadata that will be exported with my new file will be the copyright notice and copyright status I assign to each and every image while I import them into Lightroom. If you want to add a custom watermark built from within Lightroom itself, this would be the appropriate place for you to do that. I almost always do any watermarking from within Photoshop and will explain how and why in an upcoming tutorial. Then finally, I tell Lightroom to open my file in Photoshop so that I can conduct whatever additional work I intend to do there. If you are exporting from Lightroom as a watermark JPEG, then I would suggest you instead select the Show in Finder option if you're working on a Mac, Show in Explorer if you're working on a PC. And don't forget to save your settings here for use in the future. At the bottom of the preset column here in the Export dialog, press Add. Inside the new preset dialog, type in an appropriately descriptive name. I chose Facebook Covers as a new custom user preset. Next time I'll show you how to add some extras in Photoshop to transform your photograph into a photo illustration for use as a timeline cover photo. Thanks for your time, and don't forget to stop by the Phoenix Lightroom Enterprise website and its Facebook.